Let's ask what I consider to be an interesting question. So this is a bit of history of mathematics. Does every vector space have a basis? Well, I'm going to state a theorem. Theorem. Yes. Every vector space has a basis. Even the infinite dimensional ones. That every finite vector space has a basis is clear. We have a theorem that says any linearly independent set of vectors can be expanded into a basis. So take a single vector, a single non-zero vector, that's a linearly independent set, expand it into a basis. The second statement is a lot less trivial. For the second statement, we'd have to expand our definitions. I mean, our current definition of linear independence only really works if we have a finite number of vectors. But that's easily done. That's not what gave people trouble. What gave people trouble was that the argument is non-constructive. Using something called the axiom of choice. And we're not going to go into a bunch of set theory here, but the axiom of choice is one of the ZFC axioms, the now standard axiom system for set theory. In fact, it's so important in this axiom system that it gets a letter entirely to it. Self. The Z of ZFC is a name, Zermelo, and the F is also a name, Frankel, but the C stands for choice. And for several decades, during the last century, there was a major disagreement among mathematicians about whether the axiom of choice should be accepted as an axiom of set theory. Because the thing is that all arguments that use the axiom of choice end up being non-constructive. live. And what I mean by that is that the axiom tells us that something exists, but does not tell us what it is or how to describe it. So you can sort of see why this might have been a little controversial, because what's the point of knowing something exists if you can say literally nothing about it? And in particular, the axiom of choice ran directly enough in the face of a school of mathematical philosophy called constructivism, which says that mathematical objects should only be viewed as real if they can be explicitly constructed. Well, you can find constructivists today, but most mathematicians are not constructivists in this day and age. The great David Hilbert said that once that doing mathematics under constructivism is like trying to box without using your fists. And I think it's fair to say that the vast majority of working mathematicians accept the axiom of choice with very little hesitation. And once you have the axiom of choice, you have this. This digression has been historical in nature. I think it's personally interesting. I will say that in this particular class, we are only going to look at finite dimensional vector spaces.